What's up, guys? John Delarose here, the leading Hispanic voice in science fiction. I got a question from a reader about sales and quality and if there's a correlation between the two. Basically, there's a lot of people who go around on Twitter saying, you know, my comic book made X amount of money, therefore it's better than, you know, something that made Y amount of money. And really, sales basically come down to celebrity. If you are a popular comic artist, or if you're a popular writer with a name brand, or if you're a reality star and you put your name on a book or something like that, it's going to get sales that are better than somebody else's. It doesn't necessarily mean the book's good. It doesn't mean you put more time or quality into it. It doesn't mean anything except for it's a name brand that people recognize. And there's good marketing involved. There could be a book that's a breakout book, and it's due to the marketing, not the name idea of the person making it. But for the most part, it is name ID. If you look at, say, the music charts, for example, you'll find names at the top of the list like Beyonce or Madonna or somebody like that who is making a music record, and they have a very big name, and their continued success is basically just based on their big name. Most people don't view typical pop music up on the charts as having any particular quality much better than any other kind of music. Most of it's pretty bad, if we're going to be honest with each other. And you'll see this in the book charts, too, or the comic book charts also. I mean, the only books that get up in the top sellers of comic books is going to be a Batman book or a Spider-Man book, or it's got a name idea of a character or a creator that that you've known before. It doesn't necessarily mean that the book at number 100 on the list, being a random indie book or whatever, is any less valid than that one. It just means that there is name ID associated with that brand. I've got a story to go along with this. There is a science fiction book that came out probably 3, 4, 5 years ago by somebody I mildly know. I'm not going to call this person a friend because he probably doesn't want me to be calling him a friend at this point. But he suffers from a condition to where he couldn't promote himself, really couldn't get out there. Can't go on streams, can't go on the internet, can't even go on social media because he's got a crippling, debilitating illness that, you know, just takes him out of commission for days and days at a time. Took him a number of years, I think almost 20 years, to write his book because of that. And I happened to get a copy of the book going my way because I had heard of it through a friend of a friend. And I read it, and I saw immediately that this is one of the most talented writers I've ever read. The prose was amazing. The concept was great. The execution was pretty much flawless. I mean, it was Spider Robinson or Robert Heinlein level science fiction prose. And if you don't know who they are, you really should be looking them up. And it was great. And the book sold less than 100 copies. It's because he couldn't get his name out there. He didn't have money to pay for a good cover. The cover kind of looked a little bad and self-published. He didn't have a good marketing team. He didn't have anybody helping him, really. He just had his work that he put out there for 20 years worth of work to the world. It was elegant and beautiful and some of the best writing I've ever seen, and it sold less than 100 copies. And it just died on the vine. There's nothing that could make it go anywhere. There's nothing he could do about it. It had nothing to do with the quality of his book. As I said, it's one of the greatest science fiction books I've probably ever read. And it went nowhere. And that's the sad reality, is that people do not look at things based on quality. They look at things, you know, sometimes based on a cover, sometimes based on a marketing blurb. But most of it's based on identity. And that's why you see brands that are bigger brands continuing to be big, while you don't really get a lot of newer brands in pop culture. So no, there's no correlation between it. Doesn't mean that the big brands are necessarily bad or worse, but it also doesn't mean that the books that are selling less are any less valid either. You'll have to discover those for yourself. Maybe take a listen to reviewers like myself who are pretty honest about things in order to make those decisions before you buy. And that are the best way to go about things. I guess you could also rely on friends who you know have similar tastes to yours is another good way to do things. But sales don't mean much in terms of quality, that's just the way that the world works. So hopefully that answered a good question and helped out folk on the writing level for marketing a little bit. And if you like my videos and like my thoughts on writing and books and or anything at all, hit that like and subscribe button. Make sure this channel gets a little more attention because it deserves it. It's got high quality. So Thank you, everybody. I'll talk to you soon.